The world is entering an era of more catastrophic megafires, with impacts felt strongly both by nature and by human society. And what does a smart society do when facing such a huge problem? It seeks to advance its resilience using cutting-edge science as a guide. I'm Professor Apostolos Voulgarakis, AXA Chair in Wildfires and Climate at the Technica University of Crete. And in this third part of my masterclass, you'll learn what is needed to avoid the worst when it comes to megafires. Better management always starts with better prediction. And several major organizations, such as the World Economic Forum, have characterized the need for better wildfire prediction tools as urgent. Well, good news. We're making good progress on this particular topic. Let me explain. Broadly speaking, there are two types of fire modeling, local and global. Local fire modeling is a developed research field that provides detailed simulation of fire on small geographical scales, let's say tens of kilometers. It focuses on short-term prediction at timescales ranging from hours to days. As for global fire models, they provide forecasts for the whole planet and can predict fire frequency, burn area, and fire emissions with a resolution of several kilometers. Global models are more commonly used for longer-term predictions, ranging from months to decades. And while there are still advances on the local modeling front, we're mainly witnessing a step change on the global side of things. So, what are the drivers? Well, first, there is the wealth of new data that now exists. Thanks to Earth observation satellites, we now have better maps of fuel, better data on the weather, and also better data on the emissions resulting from fires. The second driver is the advances in artificial intelligence and data science. They help us deal with the large volumes of data in an automated fashion and reveal the connections between wildfires and their underlying human and physical drivers. Finally, it's the human power. We have a new generation of bold scientists who are ready to work between disciplines and tackle the challenges of big datasets and complex algorithms to address the urgent need for better fire prediction. I should stress here that the consequence of all the above is not that we can predict where and when exactly a megafire is going to happen. That would be impossible due to the stochastic nature of fires. But we can predict the increased risk of them happening, where and when the highest risk is, where fire can go if it actually happens, and what climate-relevant greenhouse gases and air pollutants will result from fires that happen. The second thing we need in the future for a better coexistence with fire is better decision-making tools for policymakers and for the private sector. Thanks to the wildfire prediction tools I just mentioned, we can better account for the impacts of fires in a variety of sectors, such as climate policy and services, air quality management, agriculture, forestry, tourism, and insurance, amongst others. And there are decision-making tools for both short-term planning and long-term planning. When it comes to short-term, the most central type of tools is early warning systems. Such systems help warn citizens, but also firefighting departments, health agencies, and hospitals of an approaching natural disaster. They can make a huge difference in avoiding material damages and even loss of lives. In Greece, for example, there is an electronic system that reaches out to every citizen when there is a serious risk of a high-impact event. Long-term decision-making tools help inform both the public and the private sector in order to follow more sustainable and less damaging pathways of development. For example, forest managers can apply more conscious fuel management, which accounts for the type of ecosystem and the increasing danger of megafires. Urban planners and insurers can make more well-informed decisions based on the forecasts of fire risk in the future in key areas of urban expansion. And farmers can know what crops are more resilient to changes in the fire regimes in the future. What all this leads to is a better informed, but also better prepared society. And here, let's not forget that alongside tools, educational programs are also crucial. Understanding the diverse face of fires in different world regions will empower communities and allow them to have a more balanced coexistence with fire in the future. To wrap things up, better managing fires relies on better prediction tools and better decision-making tools. The good news is that we're witnessing a step change in fire modeling thanks to big data, artificial intelligence, and cross-disciplinary teams. Thanks to this, we're coming up with effective decision-making tools for both short-term planning and long-term planning. But let's not forget that educational programs are also needed if we want to help communities understand how to live more sustainably with fires in their own environment. So, you see, we can still win the battle against megafires, and you can play a part in it.